From Anshei Sfard, Bethel MF Congregation, it's time to take 10 minutes for Torah with Rabbi Joel Finkelstein.
Welcome to our discussion of Parshat Baalotcha, Eldad and Medad, Unlikely Heroes. Look in the Torah, there's a story that's it's full of questions, riddled with questions. Moshe complained that he couldn't handle the difficult task of running the Jewish people. God says, don't worry, we'll put your spirit on 70 elders. He puts the spirit on them. And then there were two other people who also had the spirit, and they're in the scriptures, they're written, Hema Baktuvim, what does that mean? They didn't go out to the tent, what does that mean? And they also prophesied. There was a young lad, it was Joshua, he was concerned. He told Moshe to either put them in jail or put an end to them, put an end to their prophecy. And Moshe says, what are you worried about? What are you, jealous for me? Let it be that all the Jewish people would be prophets. Miten kolam Hashem nevi'im, kiten Hashem et ruchu aleihem. Let God give his spirit to everybody. That's the story. It's strange. If they weren't supposed to get the prophecy, why did they get the prophecy? They were supposed to get the prophecy, then why weren't they part of the 70? What's going on? If you look in the Me'am Loez, he quotes from the Al-Sheikh. He says it works like this. As Rashi explains, if there's supposed to be 70 elders, well, do the math. There's 12 tribes, 70 elders. You could have 5 from each tribe. That would leave 60. That's 10 extra. Those 10, you could give one of each of the 10 of 12 tribes, you could give them an extra leader. So most tribes would have 6 leaders out of the 70, and 2 tribes would be stuck with only 5 leaders. So what's he going to do? So he said, we'll make a lottery. I'll write 72 pieces of paper. You'll have 6 from each tribe. 6 times 12, 72. And 2 people will get stuck from whatever tribe. They won't have leaders. Their little slip of paper will be blank. The others, it'll say, Zaken, you're an elder. Now, unbeknownst to Moshe, there were 2 gentlemen, Eldad and Medad, who either, according to an interesting tradition that the Balei HaTosfot say, that there was someone, a certain Rav Amram, son of Hillel, who he went to Israel and he saw the grave of Eldad and Medad, and it says that they were half-brothers of Moses, brothers of Aaron. Half-brothers of Aaron. Strange. They were actually related to Moshe. Strange. How does that fit? And they're not part of the tribes. Maybe they were. That's not clear. Others say no. These are the leaders. Eldad and Medad are mentioned later on. They're from the tribes of Ephraim and Binyamin. Okay. So they say to themselves, you know what? We're going to lose this lottery. We're not going to be part of this lottery. We're not worthy of being one of the 70 elders. So they didn't go. Hey, they didn't go out to the tent to be with Moshe for the election. They stayed home. But Hema Baktuvim, they're among those who were written in. Their lottery actually was supposed to be one of the elders. You see, these 2 people didn't show up. So the 68 people were picked. And who were the other 2? So Eldad Umedad, they prophesied without being there. And that was strange. Yoshua thought it was strange. Moshe said, there's no problem. They were meant to be. And there's no problem at all. What did they prophesy? So Rashi says that they said that Moshe was going to die and Joshua would take the Jews into Israel. Now, of course, later on we learn that to be true. But at this point, they're marching toward Israel. There's no reason to assume that that would happen. So Joshua is quite upset. He should be happy for himself that he's going to lead the Jews, but he's not. He's upset for Moshe that people are discrediting his leadership. And Moshe says, maybe he knew that something would happen. Moshe says, well, don't be jealous for me. There's no problem. We see here in this story that the idea of modesty within leadership is emphasized a number of times over. Firstly, we have Moshe. Later on in the parsha, Aish Moshe Anav Miod Mikol Adam Asher Al Pnei Adamah. Moses is more modest than anyone in the whole world. So the greatness of Moshe, it's not unrelated to the fact that he is one of the most modest. He didn't want to lead, he doesn't want to lead. Yehoshua should be happy that indeed Moshe will die and Joshua will take the Jews into the land of Israel. After all, many people would be happy if they're going to be the leader. But he was modest. He was interested in his Rebbe, his teacher, who wasn't interested in his grandeur. And Eldad and Medad, they assumed that they were not worthy to be part of anything. They were related, according to one idea, they're related to Aaron. Aaron is the type of person, he's happy for others. He's not interested in the glory for himself. He's happy that Moshe is the leader. Or they were from the tribes of Ephraim and Binyamin. Those are the youngest tribes. See, Ephraim is really the youngest of Ephraim and Manasseh. Ephraim is the youngest. And he's from the next generation, the grandchildren of Yaakov. And Binyamin is the youngest son. So they figured, we're from the youngest tribes. We can't be the leaders. Interesting, what happened? In fact, who were the first leaders? The first leader is Joshua from Ephraim. And the first king is Saul, or Shaul, from Ephraim, from Binyamin. So it's interesting that in the end, God's interested in leadership from the Tzeir, from the youngest of tribes. He's interested in modest leadership. This idea that there's no room for haughtiness, that when a leader has haughtiness, who knows what the end then might makes right, who knows what happens when a leader comes to haughtiness. The whole idea is that if you want to have spirituality, connection with God, we need to understand how small we are, how great God is, and that always leads to modesty. Person keeps that in mind. When a person has that modesty and understanding that even if they are one of the 70 chosen ones, even if you're the Moshe Rabbeinu, you're the chosen one, there has to be that continued understanding that of the katnus ha'adam, the fact that ultimately human being is small, undeserving. And from that place of modesty and feeling undeserving, then greatness can come. What we have in this parsha is a whole crew of great Jewish leaders who didn't feel themselves to be great. And that's the beginning of greatness, is to understand how limited we are. And from that place of limited, feeling limited, that's where greatness begins. Thank you for joining us here at the Anshei Sefarad Beth El Emeth congregation for a discussion of Parshat Baalotcha. Join us each week for our discussions, parsha, holidays, various aspects of Torah life. Thanks to our producer, Jason Lefkowitz, and thank you for joining us.
This has been 10 Minutes for Torah with Rabbi Joel Finkelstein. To learn more, visit asby.org.